Hello and welcome to today's tutorial on how to use PeriApp in BIM Perform. This innovative function offers the possibility to plan and configure shoring systems. Let's get started. The PeriApp systems can be found in the multifunction toolbar under the manufacturer Peri. There you will find the two main commands, PeriApp Flex and Aside Extension. These are the commands we will focus on today. When you click on the PeriApp Flex command, select a point wherever you want to place the support scaffold and a section or side view. Define the height by clicking a setup level and a limiting ceiling level. A window will then appear where you can define the properties of the support scaffold. Let's take a closer look. Upon first glance, you will notice three categories in the tab: System Selection, System Settings, and Item Selection. First, choose your preferences for the support scaffold in the System Selection. Here, you can choose between PeriApp Flex and PeriApp Flex 2. You might wonder about the difference between these two systems. PeriApp Flex focuses on base stem UVB24, while PeriApp Flex 2 focuses on base stem UVB25. However, one does not exclude the other. PeriApp Flex has vertical stems UVA ranging from 500 to 4000 mm and vertical stems UVH ranging from 1000 to 2500 mm, whereas PeriApp Flex 2 features vertical stems UVR2 from 500 to 3000 mm and vertical stems UVH2 from 500 to 2500 mm. Both systems share identical head and base spindles. Now that we've clarified that, let's move on to the additional options. Here, you can choose between the standard support scaffold, additional ledges, and horizontal bulkheads, which greatly influence the appearance of your support scaffold. Next, proceed to system settings. Here, you can select the head for the support scaffold, either cross fork head or head spindle, and specify their orientation in the X or Y direction. The final step in system settings is to define the width and length in meters. Once all these selections are made, move to Item Selection to make adjustments for UVB, UVR, and UVH. To save and apply the settings, simply click OK. Another window will appear where you can select the configuration option, such as the standard solution or one of the many alternative combinations offered. Click OK, and a third window will appear where you can choose the spindle extension from bottom to top. This completes the process and your preferred support scaffold will be placed in just seconds. From here, you can add a side extension next to the support scaffold by clicking on the Side Extension command. Choose the side of the support scaffold where the extension should be placed, then select a frame size between 0.25 to 3 meters and click OK. Within moments, the side extension will be seamlessly integrated with the adjacent support scaffold. Note that the side extension uses the same settings as the first command. This can be done regardless of whether you are using a standard support scaffold, one with additional ledges, or one with a horizontal bulkhead. The same applies to PeriApp Flex 2, regardless of the system's orientation or head type. Lastly, you have the option to switch between model groups after placing your support scaffold. Simply select the system, go to the Properties panel, and click on Model Group. A variety of groups will be available for you to choose from, allowing you to change the appearance of the support scaffold as needed. You can switch between groups freely and revert to the original group at any time without altering its properties. And that concludes today's tutorial. With the new PeriUp feature in Bintiform for Autodesk Revit, you have all the tools you need to precisely and efficiently plan your shoring systems. Try it out yourself and discover the benefits of this feature in your projects. For more information, visit our website and contact us to get a 14 days free trial of Bintiform.